My name's Nick Short. I'm a vet who works at the Royal Veterinary College, and I'm responsible for our electronic media. This is an interesting photograph which shows the gravid or pregnant uterus of a cat. There are four round balls which each contain a cat fetus and a fifth ball which has actually been opened and dissected. Outside that ball, to the top right, you'll see a very small fetus. That is a very early cat fetus, which is still connected by its umbilical cord to the placenta. You can see at the bottom of the picture that there is just a short section, which is the cervix, through which these fetuses will pass, usually about 61 to 65 days after implantation. That's the gestation period of a cat. You can see the two ovaries, the top left and right, and these are connected to the body wall through a ligament with blood supply. In a neutering operation, which we call spaying, we remove the whole section, all the tissues you can see in this photograph. So we'll ligate or tie off the tissue which connects the ovaries to the body wall, so that blood supply is restricted. And we'll also ligate and cut the cervix so that there's no leakage from the cervix. And this whole section of uterine horn and ovaries will be removed. We don't know where this specimen comes from, but clearly it could have been collected from a dead cat, which may have been put to sleep, perhaps because it had some other condition, or it could also have been from a surgical procedure where the cat was pregnant when the uterus was removed. This is a beautiful image of a bovine uterus. You can see in the picture that in the right-hand uterine horn, a window has been cut into the wall of the horn, and through that window we can see a number of round protrusions on the wall of the uterus, the endometrium, and also in the flap that's been cut away to the right, you can see four of these protrusions. These are called caruncles, and they're actually the structures which connect to the placenta of the fetus and provide the interface between the dam's blood system and the fetus and provide an opportunity for nutrients to pass from the dam to the fetus. The uterus has two horns, and you can see on the left-hand side at the very end of the uterine horn, there's a small ovary tucked into the corner. When we as vets examine a cow to determine whether it's pregnant, we will actually feel the whole uterus through the rectum, and we'll also be able to detect and feel that ovary to determine whether the cow is pregnant. With good technique, it's possible to detect a pregnancy down to 6 weeks of age. This is a really unusual photograph of a red deer uterus, which is a pregnant uterus where the fetus has actually been removed. In the wall of the uterus, we can see a series of round ball-like structures, which are called cotyledons. On the surface of these structures, you can see the red arteries, which have been filled with a red latex to make them clear, and also the blue vessels, which are the veins, which drain the blood from these cotyledons. I think this makes it very clear that these structures are very vascular, and this is important to provide nutrients to the fetus. If you look to the right of the uterus, you can see there's two vessels which have cut, and you can see the open lumen of those vessels. These are part of the umbilical cord, which connects, of course, to the fetus and provides nutrient supply. Usually, with red deer, they only have one fetus in the uterus at a time, which we call a fawn, and the gestation period, or the length of pregnancy, is about 240 days. Once the fetus is born, it tends to be about 15 kilograms in weight, which is quite a size. You can see not only the uterus, but at the bottom of the picture, you can see the cervix through which the fetus will pass on its way out into the open. This is a fascinating picture. It shows the uterus of a wallaby. Now, wallabies are marsupials, which are unusual in that they have paired vagina, cervix, and uterus, and these can be seen in this structure. At the bottom of the picture, we see the cervix, and to the left, the shrunk and shriveled structure pointing to the left is actually the bladder. And we can see that coming into the bladder on the right-hand edge of the bladder is the ureter, which has come down from the kidney. The middle structure, which looks like a double-coiled tube, is the uterus. The other thing that's fascinating about the reproductive structures of the wallaby is that there are three vagina. There's one on the right and left, which are the lateral vagina, and the central vagina, which goes down to the cervix. The lateral vagina are where the semen enter into the uterus. The middle vagina is where the fetus is born. To the top of the picture, we can actually see the uterine horns. These are separate, unique horns. And what's fascinating also about the marsupial is that only one horn is pregnant at one time. The left horn may be pregnant initially. Once that fetus is born, the right horn becomes pregnant. And actually, if you look up the side of the horn, you can see two small ovaries attached to the horns themselves. Another interesting feature of the marsupial's reproductive system is that the fetus is actually born at a very early stage of development, about 27 days of gestation. So at this stage, it's still very immature, and incredibly, it crawls out through the reproductive system and then exits the vagina and climbs up the fur of the mother and gets into the pouch of the mother, where it attaches the teat and then develops further in the pouch. This amazing photograph captures the fetus of a foal within or just extracted from the uterus of a mare. The fetus has been extracted from the uterus and is still encased by the amniotic and chorionic membranes. So it's quite an amazing dissection, a very, very difficult dissection to do. This would be more than 2 foot in length, so it's quite a big structure. You can see on the right side of the fetus, two of the hooves sticking out, and you can see already how they're formed in a shape very similar to the adult in a very miniature version. To the left of the feet, we can see a thick cord, which is the umbilical cord, and is crucial for the blood supply to the fetus, bringing nutrients and draining waste materials from the foal. If you look in the uterus itself, the wall of the uterus, you can see the blood vessels running along the surface of the endometrium or the wall of the uterus, and you can also see the rich blood supply in the lining of the uterus, which is crucial to providing the nutrients for the fetus as well. The image itself was taken of a specimen at the Royal Veterinary College, collected from a New Forest pony many, many years ago. We don't know exactly the circumstances, but we suspect that the New Forest ponies, which are regularly culled, one of these was probably sent to the Royal Veterinary College for dissection. As this fetus is only about 5 months of age, the mare, which was carrying the fetus, would not have shown any signs of pregnancy. And for this reason, if nothing else, it wouldn't have been an issue when the animal was culled. This disturbing photograph shows a specimen that we have at the Royal Veterinary College of two conjoined piglets, deformities, clearly, which are near term, as you can see from the level of development of the hair and the features, the face and the tail of the piglets. As vets, we're well aware that these conjoined fetuses can cause many problems because the size and the bulk of the joined fetuses means that they can't pass naturally through the vagina. And so we get what we call dystochia or difficult birth. And for this reason, usually the only way to remove these fetuses is through a cesarean. In these cases, the piglets are not viable and they are usually dead on birth. But one has to remove them because otherwise the sow would have a mummified fetus. In this case, we can see that the piglets are conjoined both in the face and also at the body level. This particular condition is called cephalopagus. This is a small rhesus monkey. We can detect the ear, the feet and the hands and the skull. And interestingly enough, which is perhaps not immediately apparent, from the bottom right-hand corner, going up to the top left behind the ear, is the long tail wound around the head. Under the right armpit, we can see the umbilical cord, which attaches to the discoid placenta, which is just behind the fetus at the back. This fetus would still be in utero. It had not been born as yet. And we can see that it's encased in the chorion and amnion membranes, which are very fine membranes within which are the fluids which surround the fetus. To dissect a fetus like this would involve a lot of work, but clearly those membranes are very fine and are quite easily broken. But this is a perfect specimen, absolutely amazing the way it's been captured.
My name is Michael Frank. I'm a professional photographer. Coming from advertising, I kind of got into it, like taking an advertising shot. So it's kind of on black background, and also because you can't actually take the specimen out of the jars. So you have to work around the pot. So everything around is black. I set up the lights in order not to have reflections, and also to emphasize the roundness of the specimen. This kind of evolved over time, because at the beginning it was just shots of the pots for the website. And then I actually realized that they looked actually like art pieces. And that's where the idea came of removing the pot in post-production. So basically in Photoshop, like cutting it out and cleaning, because lots of these pots are quite old. And you have a lot of scratches on it, and so it's quite a long process. As the winner of the Wellcome Image Award 2015, it was a great privilege and also a great surprise for me to win this award, not being an academic and not having to do with veterinary or other things. My favorite image out of this would be actually the one that won the overall prize, so the equine fetus, which is also, strange enough, the first image of the whole series we did. So the whole collection started from this image, so it was kind of great.